Donald Trump's 2020 campaign manager has said Snapchat is trying to rig the 2020 election after it stopped promoting the president's content. The photo sharing and chatting app, popular with teenagers, confirmed yesterday that it would no longer display Trump promotions on its Discover tab, which shows posts and advertising of high-profile users, including politicians and celebrities. Following the precedent recently set by Twitter, the firm said its decision was linked to social media comments by the president alluding to state violence. "We will not amplify voices who incite racial violence and injustice by giving them free promotion on Discover," the official Snap statement said. "Racial violence and injustice have no place in our society, and we stand together with all who seek peace, love, equality, and justice in America." The decision prompted a response from Brad Parscale, who described Snapchat boss Evan Spiegel as radical and suggested the app had an anti-conservative bias. Parscale said, "Snapchat is trying to rig the 2020 election, illegally using their corporate funding to promote Joe Biden and suppress President Trump." Radical Snapchat CEO Evan Spiegel would rather promote extreme left riot videos and encourage their users to destroy America than share the positive words of unity, justice, and law and order from our president. Snapchat hates that so many of their users watch the president's content, and so they are actively engaging in voter suppression. If you're a conservative, they do not want to hear from you, they do not want you to vote. They view you as a deplorable and they do not want you to exist on their platform," he said, using a term that was co-opted in 2016 after being used as an attack on Trump supporters by Democratic candidate Hillary Clinton. According to Statista, just over half of Snapchat users in the U.S. were between 15 and 25 years old as of Q3 last year, followed by 26 to 35 years old at roughly 33%. Bloomberg reported last month Trump has amassed more than 1.5 million followers on the platform. "It is viewed as important to the 2020 campaigning effort as it is being used by a younger demographic, some on the cusp of voting for the first time." Despite losing the promotional privileges, Trump's account remains active. The changes mean promotional content will now only be seen by those who subscribe. Democratic rival Joe Biden, running against Trump in the upcoming presidential election, responded to the news via his own Snapchat account. "I just wanted to tell you I'm proud to be able to run for president and still be on Snapchat," Biden said. Joe Biden weighs in on Snapchat's decision to stop promoting Trump's account. "I just wanted to tell you I'm proud to be able to run for president and still be on Snapchat." The decision to remove Trump from Discover was a result of tweets threatening to use vicious dogs and ominous weapons against U.S. citizens protesting the killing of George Floyd by police officers in Minneapolis, The New York Times reported. Last week, Twitter put a warning label on a tweet by the president that contained the phrase, "When the looting starts, the shooting starts," as it was deemed to be glorifying violence. Facebook did not remove the post, sparking protests by employees.